Good morning. It is Wednesday, so we're back together for some time of devoted faith together. Hope you all are enjoying this nice weather we've been having, and that you're feeling yourself a little refreshed and excited for what's coming our way very shortly. I've been reading in Genesis this week, and I was reading the story about how the Lord promised Abraham and Sarah that they were going to have many descendants. And in reading that, of course, many of us know that Sarah took matters into her own hands when the Lord told Abram that he was going to give him lots of sons. And she took matters into her own hands, being very concerned about her age and the ability that the fact that she had not been able to have children. And so she took matters into her own hands and had Abram go and have relations with one of her servants, who in fact became pregnant. And from that, we know that a son, Ishmael, was born. When I was reading that this week, I read it more than once because it dawned on me, what would have happened if Sarah had just trusted God? What would have been the outcome of that story? You know, many times I personally am very guilty of the fact that I don't necessarily rely on God's timing to be perfect in my life. I pray about something, and if I don't hear an answer, you know, in 0.4 seconds, then I'm ready to take matters into my own hands more often than not. And I'm sure that many of you can relate to that. But what would happen if we got really good at just trusting God's perfect timing? We know that all things that God does is for our good and for His glory. And if we would just claim that and we would own that on a day-to-day basis, the things that are bogging us down or bothering us are the things that we need to be trusting God with. If we waited for His timing to in fact be perfect instead of taking matters into our own hands, I really think that the stresses in our lives and the things that are just really out of our control anyway really would become much more manageable if we would just trust the fact that God's timing is perfect. I know that for me, waiting on the Lord sometimes is very hard, and I know that that can be hard for many of you. But what if this week we really practiced on waiting on the Lord and waiting for His timing to be perfect? I wonder what those outcomes of those moments would be for us. It's an exciting thing to think about, hard to do, but certainly something we should be challenging ourselves to do. You guys have a great week. Enjoy the sunshine, and we'll be back together again real soon.